So dear students, we were doing discussion of the question answer named chapter The Bond of Love. Yesterday we were able to discuss first three questions. Have you done those questions in your prayer notebooks? When will you do? So you do these three questions in your prayer notebook. So let's continue with the same chapter. Only three we have discussed. See, these three questions we have discussed. Okay, so I'm going to give you some of the extra questions because three are not sufficient. Because in this chapter, there are so many details to be done. Okay, so start writing. And I want active participation of yours in the discussion of question answers. Bachche, maintain silence. Sit quietly. So write down question. Because today I have planned to discuss some of the MCQs also with you. So write down first question. Who was Bruno and how was it caught by the narrator? Who was Bruno and how he was caught by the narrator? So this is extra questions. This is extra question I have given you. Jot down. You have to do these questions in your fair notebook also. And I want answer. I don't want to see your blank response. Very simple questions I'm going to discuss. But there is a long list of questions. Better you write down in your notebook instead of writing on book only. Okay, so Ritik, you tell me who was Bruno and how he was caught by the narrator. Your name? Shivraj. You tell me. Stand up and tell me this answer. Who was Bruno? And
Bruno was a small baby bear. Bruno was a small baby bear. His mother was shot. His mother was shot. Then and he was found alone. Then the narrator and his wife took away their baby.
Good. Very good. Your answer was perfectly all right. Now, Nitish, you come forward and tell me the answer. Come here. After that, Shivraj, you should be ready. Yes.
During his trip to Mysore, he was right, and then he saw a man kill his mother and then
he. Yes, very good. So Bruno was basically a sloth bear, okay, and he was caught in an accident, okay. Narrator and his friends, they were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. Okay, and Bruno's mother was shot dead. And narrator captured Bruno and from the sugarcane field and he put it in which bag? Yes. So you have to write down all these details also. Where did he found? Okay, Where did he capture him? Where was it kept? Okay, so this answer is clear. Now let's move to next question. Very beautiful question. How did Bruno become attached to the family of the author? No, one by one I can call any of the child. So for this answer, I have planned to call. Pricks. Pricks. Okay, beta, you come. Daily I will be announcing this thing and Divyanshi and Vanshika should not sit together. Beta, this is a question. Screen is not visible. Ikjot, screen is not visible to you. Okay, Divya, you come. You require 2 minutes for framing this answer. So strange. This answer is so simple. We have spent 3 days on this chapter. 3 periods are given to this chapter. Arzu, you come. Simran, you all should be ready. Any of the child can be called to tell me. Suppose this answer is of 2-3 marks, then 5-6 lines are sufficient.
Bruno was a sloth baby bear who lost its parents and was crying pitifully, and narrator caught him by an accident. As he was a kind-hearted person, narrator softened at the scene in front of him, so he captured Bruno. After coming home, Bruno became attached to the family of the author because of the care provided to him by them. They used to feed him, and narrator's wife also kept his name Bruno. And the 2 Alsatian's dog that narrator had also prayed with Bruno. So slowly and slowly he became close to the family.
Now, Arzu, come. No, I don't want to give you 1 minute more. Whatever you know, you speak in your own words.
Bruno was a sloth bear and he was attached to his family members, especially his wife. It had to be sent away to the zoo because it was getting too big to keep at home. It was so difficult for them to handle.
No, these lines are not to be added in this answer. The question is, how did Bruno become attached to the family of the author? I'm not asking that why he has to be sent to the zoo. The question is why? How did he become attached? What was the reason? He was getting what? Love, affection, care. Good food was also provided to him. So he was treated just like a baby of a family. Children of parents were also playing with him. So this was the reason. Narrator's wife was giving him lots of care just like as his. As her own baby. So these were the basic reasons, isn't it? Divya.
Bruno was a baby sloth bear who accidentally got abandoned. Since he was a child, he was kept like a baby in the house. They were emotionally attached to each other. Baba's wife, narrator's wife, used to give Baba gallons of food. He used to perform various tricks which entertain everybody. When Baba used to get sick, everyone used to become very sad. When he got segregated from the narrator's wife, she was very, very sad and she refused to eat the food. There was a bond of affection between Baba and narrator's wife.
You have repeated the word used to. Don't do repetition. Otherwise, content was good. So this answer is clear. You can tell other things also that he was taught different kind of tricks also. Okay. So he was treated just like a family member. So there was a special place in the family. They treated him just like their own child. Okay, tenants' children were playing, Alsatian dogs were playing. Okay, narrator and his wife was taking care of him. He was also enjoying different kind of foods which were provided by them. Okay, so he was not treated just like a pet or an animal there. He was treated just like as their own family member. So this was the reason. Clear? Bruno once got paralysis. So in this answer, you have to tell all the things in very much detail that how did he get paralysis? What was the reason? What did he intake? And why did he intake that thing? So, and after that, what treatment was given to him? And how he was cured with that treatment? So start framing this answer. Cured means treatment. How did he recover? So start writing, because until unless you write, you're not able to understand. I don't want to see your books here. Whenever you come here, you should come along with your notebooks. So many details should be written there, and put good vocabulary words also. Keep tense also in your mind. Which tense you have to use? Past tense. Okay. So Dhiren has raised his hand. Okay, Dhiren, what you have written?
Yes, ma'am. Bruno was a baby sloth bear, but also a mischievous and notorious one. He liked to eat things which could also go around his neck in relish. One day he ate barium carbonate, a poisonous thing which was kept to kill rat in the library. But after that, it was obviously that he had paralysis in him and he couldn't move on his thumbs. He barely made him move till the narrator's wife, who got him to the narrator, and then it was taken to the vet. The vet looked some in the index and gave him 10 cc in antidotes three times. And after an hour of vomiting and stertorous breathing, Bruno was cured and he was standing on his toes.
Good. Very good. He has arranged all the ideas so beautifully. And there are other 7 participants in my class from online. Who is going to tell me this answer? Jayati is not participating nowadays. What happened to Jayati? Huh? Yes, Jayati, your answer is ready or not?
Yes, ma'am, it's ready.
Yes, tell me.
Bruno was a mischievous and playful pet. He liked to play around and he enjoyed every kind of food and drink. But once a time, Bruno went to the library of the narrator and by chance he consumed barium carbonate, a kind of poison which had been kept by the narrator to kill the rats. The poison soon showed his effect and Bruno suffered from an attack of paralysis. However, he managed to reach the narrator's wife, who at once informed her husband. Then Bruno was immediately taken to the vet, who administered and gave him two antidotes of 10 cc each to the bear. Bruno soon got well and started eating like normal.
When 10 cc was given to him, he did not respond. So after that, another dose of 10 cc, another 10 cc dot was given, then he started recovering. Yes.
Mama okay. said that he was given two doses.
Okay, your answer is right. Good. Now, bache, write down next question. What were the activities that Bruno did? So you go through the text again and find out all the activities. Yug, why are you feeling sleepy? You're not well. So what were the activities that Bruno did in the story? So you find out what kind of activities were there. You go. Wash your face and drink water. Go. Who is that? Otherwise, he is okay. Manshika, what do you want? You do your work. So make a list of all the activities that Bruno used to do in the house. All of you. Yes, answer is ready. Okay, Dipanshi, you have come after so many days. What happened to you? I asked you. Now you are okay. So have you gone through the story? Dipanshi, have you gone through the story? Yes. You have to make a list of all the activities and tricks that were performed by Bruno. So what were those activities? I don't want to listen all the things in Hindi.
He used to hold the stick.
This is not the way to tell me the answer. Frame answer in your notebook. Come here and then speak. Okay, now I'm going to call Pranchi. Your answer is ready. You require 2 minutes for every answer. Ramanjeet. Sumati. Okay, she requires less time. Others require 2 minutes, she requires 1 minute. Renuka. Who is ready with the answer? Okay, Aditya, you come.
He used to tackle anyone who came in front of him for a rough and a tumble. And whenever he was given a stick and said to hold a gun, he used to point it at someone, and it was seen nice.
So in the story, it is told that different kind of tricks and activities were performed by him, like wrestling act, like a baby, okay? So, boxing also, pointing a bamboo stick like a gun, okay? And cradling a stump like a baby, okay? So he used to play with dogs, children also. So he was, you can say, a very perfect entertainer for the family. So such kind of activities he used to do. So who were asking for 2 minutes, their answer is ready or not? Or they require 2 hours? Pranshi, come.
The activities that Bruno did in the story was Baba whistle or Baba box. He forcefully tracked anyone who came forward, say Baba hold gun and point, and he pointed after giving a stick and many more tricks.
Wrestling, boxing, to behave. Yes, pointing a bamboo stick like a gun, to cradle a stump. So all these activities. Affectionate is a word. Affectionate. Yes, you can also write. So write down next. Why was it decided? To send Bruno. Why was it decided to send Bruno to the zoo? So why this decision was taken to send Bruno to the zoo? This is not the way. Come here. Come here. Very good. Okay, you stand, Kavandur, and tell me also.
He was not able to take care of them because he takes so many efforts and so many efforts to take care of some wild deer. That's why the greater and his wife decided to send him to the zoo.
See, whatever you have spoken, you write down this answer in your notebook. Then you will come to know about all the grammatical mistakes that you are committing in every sentence. Start writing. I'll be checking. Divyanshi, come here. Good, very good. Yog.
After Uno was a giant sized bear, it was difficult for him to build the house, and it was also difficult for the narrator and his wife to take care of her. And it was take care of him, and it was dangerous for the children.
Sit down. Okay, good. See, when Bruno was brought to the house, what was its size? It was so small, so tiny. It was just like a cub. Okay, but now when food was provided with to them, when good diet was given to him, he was taken care of, and with the passage of time, his size also grew. Now his size was equal to, you can say, two Alsatians, dogs, even you can say more than them, more than, okay. So he was grown very huge, he was grown in size, okay. And it was very much difficult and challenging task to keep such a big animal too at home. And moreover, it was also a dangerous for children of tenants, okay. So that's why they made up their mind, they took a decision to shift him to the zoo, because such a giant animal should be kept at house. It was really a challenging task. It requires a lot of efforts. It was really a tedious job.
Excuse me, ma'am.
So write down tedious means difficult job. Yes, Diren?
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am, can we write that it has grown up, so it requires a lot of food also?
Yes, you can also add a clear. So now, very beautiful question. Last one I'm going to tell you. What do we learn? What do we learn from this chapter? The bond of love. What do we learn from this chapter, the bond of love? You start writing. I can ask you this answer, but I want this answer should be full of values that you have learned from this chapter. And let me take a round. Let me see what you people are doing. What you people are writing. Let me see. Arvind, what have you written? Speak. Yes, Arvind. Yes, whatever you have framed, it was good. Raghav, you stand up and tell me this answer. No problem, you can speak one, two lines. Okay, Ikjot, you tell me this answer from online class.
Yes, ma'am. The story brings out a well-known fact that love knows no barrier, whether it be any language, gender, nationality, or animal. The narrator brings a cub to his house. Then a bond of love develops between his wife and the baby bear so much that they can't live separately from each other. When Bruno is sent to the zoo, neither the baby bear eats anything nor does the narrator's wife. Ultimately, Bruno is brought back home. The author has brought forth the inherent good quality of every human being.
Okay, good. Written well. Afterwards, Laksh Jairath, you tell me the same answer. Because you people were talking, you were not writing at all. This is the reason. So there are so many values that we have learned from this chapter. The first value we have learned that there can be a love, there can be a bond of love between animal and human being also. And second thing we have learned that if we give love to animals, so they will give you same thing. So whatever we give, we get. So this is the main thing. And love doesn't know any kind of barrier, any kind of language, any kind of religion or region, because when it was brought to the family, it was just like a very small baby, like a cub. But when it was given proper care, love and affection, and it outgrew, so it became so attached that it was not ready to live without narrator's wife. Okay? And narrator's wife, she also became fond of that small bear. Okay? So we will... You do the question answers of this chapter in your notebook.